today we are here to present you about comparing and contrasting of two companies in the same industry. So we have selected two companies, UB Finance and Mercantile Investment. Before starting the presentation, I would like to introduce our team members, myself Narakshana, Jigamki, Sadam, Sumati and Usman. Looking into the presentation, these are the contents that we have included in our presentation. About the industry, company introduction, PESTEL analysis is external tool, financial analysis internal tool, and SWOT analysis, conclusion, recommendation. And these are few competitors in the same industry, like People's Leasing and Finance PLC, Central Finance, LB Finance, Singer Finance, Capital Leasing. And here I'm going to compare both the companies, Mercantile Investment and UB Finance, with incorporation service, capital base, existing branches, market share, and total asset base. So, Mercantile Investment has incorporated in 1964, June 15, whereas UB Finance incorporated in 1961, July 12. And Mercantile Investment provides services such as vehicle leasing, leasing facilities, fixed deposits, microfinance solutions, business loans, personal loans, mortgage-backed loans, as well as pledged loans facilities. Whereas UB Finance provides services including fixed deposits, savings, real estates, leasing, hire purchase, loan factoring and pawning solutions. Whereas Mercantile Investment doesn't involve into real estate and leasing, but UB Finance also was not included into mortgage-backed loan as well as the flex loan facilities. And when it comes to branches, Mercantile Investment has over 36 branches, whereas UB Finance has only 16 branches. And Mercantile share, in market share, Mercantile Investment has 2.87% and UB Finance has 1.89%. And with total asset base, Mercantile Investment has around 40.3 billion, whereas UB Finance has around 8.2 billion. So when comparing to both Mercantile Investment and UB Finance, Mercantile Investment play a better role in the industry. And moving into PESTEL analysis, when it comes to political, the instability of government will negatively affect the financial institutions. And when we focus into economical, continuous fluctuation in both tax rates and investment rates. When it comes to social, certain people doesn't like to involve in interests such as Muslim people. So, but the companies has to do is they have to innovate products which customers need, and they have to if they really want to grow into the market, they have to introduce more innovative ideas. And when it comes to technological, UB Finance has an advantage to use the latest technology which is used by their mother companies, whereas Mercantile Investment doesn't have that advantage. They need to buy new technologies and they need to take time to adapt to it. And environmental factors, natural disasters and environmental changes can negatively affect many businesses and individuals. Since their focus on an advances, it will be difficult to recover these barriers. And when we focus into legal factor, all legal procedures related to financial institutions are made by Central Bank Sri Lanka. Therefore, both the companies need to comply with the Central Bank's rules and regulation. So, from this point onward, I'm giving the presentation over to Jinanti.
Thank you, Nirakshana. I'll be doing the financial analysis part. I will take out a few figures from here and explain you the financial analysis. First, I'll take the gross profit. As you can see, the gross profit of Mercantile Investments is higher than the gross profit of UB Finance, The gross profit ratio of mercantile investments is 44.4%, whereas gross profit ratio of UB Finance is 39.50%, which means mercantile investments has the ability to generate more gross income than the UB Finance. Then I'll take profit after tax, PAT. For UB Finance, it is 67.5 million, and for mercantile investments, it is 202 million rupees, which means, as you can see, the mercantile investments, the PAT is almost around 3 times of UB Finance's PAT. And next, I will take net profit ratio. The mercantile investments net profit ratio is 3.6%, whereas UB Finance's net profit ratio is 4.3%. UB Finance stays ahead of mercantile investments with this 4.3% net profit ratio, but still it is not adequate enough because the minimum requirement of net profit ratio is 10%. So even though the UB Finance stays ahead of mercantile investments, it is still not adequate enough. And when we take effective tax rate, you can see the UB Finances is maintaining a 27.67% effective tax rate, while mercantile investments maintains a 35.59% effective tax rate. The standard corporate tax rate in Sri Lanka is 28%. So UB Finance has been able to effectively manage their taxable activities, while mercantile investments has been failed to manage it effectively. Finally, the earning per share, EPS. As you can see, mercantile investments stays ahead with the 67.20 EPS, which means, which indicates that they have the ability to generate more dividends for their investors. And this is the final part, SWOT analysis. First, I'll do the SWOT analysis for the UB Finance. The strength of UB Finance is it is protected under a well-established mother company, which is Union Bank. And when we take the weaknesses of UB Finance, they have the weaknesses. It has weaknesses as the first one is the branch network. It is not wide enough to compete with the competitors because. As in the beginning, as Nidakshana said, they have only 16 branches all over the country. So their branch network is not wide enough to compete with the rivalries. And they have the absence of growing local market in neighboring countries, which is also a weakness. And when we talk about the opportunity of UB Finance, UB Finance has an internationally recognized mother company, which means the recognition of the mother company helps them to introduce, it makes it easier for them to introduce new products to the market. And the threat they have is they have to compete with other strong and powerful companies. And the SWOT analysis for mercantile investments. Mercantile investments has a strength of total capital base of over 7.7 billion rupees, and it has weakness. It has two weaknesses: the lack of innovative ideas to compete with the rivalries, and the other weakness is absence of growing local market in neighboring countries. And the opportunities mercantile investments has, they have a wide range of services, so they can share the services of each sector. And the threats, the threat they have is they have to compete with other powerful and strong companies. Finally, the recommendation. The both companies need to improve their business activities in terms of branches, products, retaining customers, and technologies. Since they are more powerful competitors in the existing market, they can crash both mercantile and UP finance companies. These are the sources we gathered information from. From here, we will write up the presentation. Thank you.
Right.